Hyperloop is a concept developed by Elon Musk, and it's basically a new means of high-speed transportation. You have an evacuated tube. It's basically a tube that's all the air has been sucked out, and you put in a pod that has some kind of aerodynamic shape. Since there's almost no air in the tube, you'll be able to coast relatively quickly. There's a lot of different designs that are proposed. We can do simulations, we can use engineering analysis to figure out what would probably work best, but since there's no real flight heritage on any of these pods, it's very difficult to find out what things work, what things don't work. You develop some form of levitation. You have to develop attitude control. Another huge one, very important, is the braking system. You need to have a flight computer. You need to be able to get the telemetry from the pod. You need to be able to read the acceleration, what kind of pitch we're getting. Purdue Hyperloop is actually one of the few teams, if not the only team, to have a fully composite structure. A lot of what you see is just carbon fiber laid out. Plus, it makes the pod look very cool if you have an aerodynamic shape. It's important, it's gotta look cool, otherwise people aren't gonna be interested. I was very fortunate enough to get to go out to SpaceX headquarters where the competition was at. And when we got there, it was just like every nerd's dream. Like, this tube was outside their headquarters and it's basically a mile long. Elon Musk was there for the competition. And it was absolutely remarkable to see all the different kinds of designs, all the different kinds of people working on it. And we were actually one of only 7 teams to get in the tube. And we're very proud of that. Basically, the next iteration of their competition, the main thing is gonna be how fast can the pod go while being able to safely decelerate and stop. We have a collaboration with UPV, which is a technical university in Valencia in Spain.
I knew about Purdue team, about the team and what they were doing here. So that was one big reason for me to come here. I thought that it could be like a really cool thing to start a transatlantic collaboration, the first one in the history of Hyperloop.
They are really helping us with the design portion of the project, as well as the avionics system. And then we at Purdue will be doing a lot of the manufacturing and construction of the actual pod itself. You definitely get that global perspective working with a university that's literally across the Atlantic Ocean.
Now we are mixing the best of both continents, the best theoretical, the best hands-on skills that we can find at Purdue. So making that team that has different, very different backgrounds, very different skills, mix them together, make them to collaborate. The whole world is interested in transforming how we move, how we go from one side of the stage to the other side. The technology is there. We have to test, we have to prove that this can work. And if that works, people want to use it. It's a great progress in transportation.
There is definite potential in seeing a Hyperloop in my lifetime. There's enough people working on it right now to overcome those technical challenges and really develop a brand new type of transportation.